Hello students, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Maths Classes. So today I am going to start exercise 7.4 from question number 10 onwards. But before that, I want to say that those who have not watched our previous video regarding the solutions of exercise 7.4 from question number 1 to 9, please click on the I link. You can get the description over there to see the solutions of exercise 7.4 from question number 1 to 9. So today from question number 10 onwards, if you will see in the book, the questions are of type this, means we are having a quadratic equation in the denominator, or we are having a linear equation in the numerator, and denominator in the denominator we are having a quadratic equation. So how to do the integration of these type of questions? So there is a perfect method or algo for these type of questions. You have to follow this method and you will again will be able to use this type of formula, because whenever we have to use this type of formula, we have to form the equation in this standard form. So let us see. In the type 1, I have written 1 upon quadratic equation. All of you know that the standard form of the quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c. So we can see here that in the denominator we are having ax square plus bx plus c. Hardly matter that whether it is without square root or with square root, in both method you have to follow the same steps. So the first step is, I hope so that all of you have remembered that complete square method which you have done in class 10 chapter number 4 quadratic equations. So you have done there how to change a particular quadratic equation into complete square. So we are just following that method only. So the first step for that is that coefficient of x square should also always be equal to 1. So if we are having any coefficient with the x square, we have to take a common. If I have taken here a common, what do I get? X square plus b upon ax plus c upon a. This is the first step. Now the next step in the complete square method is we have to add and subtract half the coefficient of x whole square. Coefficient of x means whatever the number is there with x. Here number is b upon a, that is constant. So b upon a, if we will half, so it will become b upon 2a. So we will add and subtract b upon 2a whole square. So in this way, you can see here I have done in step number 2, plus b upon 2a whole square minus b upon 2a whole square. Following this method, in the next step, you will be able to make, by combining these terms, you will always be able to make these terms in a complete square. So it becomes x plus b upon 2a whole square plus remaining two numbers will be a constant, which can be written as under root of whatever the constant is there, or we will just take a complete square of that number. So in this way, this equation will be changed into either of this form, either x square minus a square or a square minus x square, whatever the type 6 integrals we have done in the particular form, you can see there. So moving on to the next type, that is we are having, here we are not having anything in the numerator. In the numerator we are having only 1. But when moving on to this type of equations, we can see that we are having linear equation in the numerator. Linear means any equation which is having degree 1. And quadratic in the denominator, that means we are having an equation of degree 2. So what to do in this type of question? So I have written here step number 1. Step number is what? We have to take linear equation is equal to always a times derivative of denominator plus b. Here denominator we have to take the quadratic equation. Whatever the quadratic equation is there in the denominator, we have to take the derivative of that equation. Now what to do? You have to do the derivative of this equation. It becomes 2ax plus b, and b is a constant, you have to write them as it is. Now mark this equation as 1. Now what to do? You have to just open it and compare the coefficient of x with the coefficient of x here, and the constant term with the constant term. So you will get the value of a and b. No doubt, if you will do the question, you will be able to understand it very clearly. As these are all in variables, so you are not able to understand. So please just follow the steps and we will do these steps in our questions, and from that questions you will be able to understand how to solve the particular integral. So please watch my full video for that to understand the basic concept of this exercise. So let's start now. So students, let's see how to do question number 10. In question number 10, you can see that we are having a quadratic equation in the denominator. This is the quadratic equation. So first of all, we have to follow the complete square method to find out the solution of this integral. So let's see how, what to do. See, the first step we don't need to do, as the coefficient of x square is 1 here. So we don't need to do anything. We have to follow from step number 2. The step number 2 is we have to add and subtract half the coefficient of x whole square. So what is the coefficient of x? Here x is, the coefficient of x is 2. So if we will half, that becomes 2 upon 2, that is 1. So we have to add and subtract 1 square. So adding 1 square and subtracting 1 square. Now the next step is, see, I'm just telling you the shortcut. If anybody gets confused, what will be the complete square in this term? So just remember this thing. Always you have to write down x. Whatever you are adding and subtracting whole square, just write down as it is and put the whole square. Now in between, you have to see either the sign plus will come or minus will come. Just remember one thing. Whatever the coefficient of x is, whatever the coefficient of x is, if it is in plus, then the sign plus will come here. If the coefficient of x is minus, then the minus sign will come here. I am repeating this thing. X as it is, whatever the term you are adding and subtracting whole square, that means you don't need to take the whole square, only the term, that means 1. And plus and minus depends upon the coefficient of x. If coefficient of x is in plus, then you have to take plus sign, and if it is in minus, then you have to take minus sign. And the remaining constants are 2 minus 1 square will become 1. So it becomes x plus 1 whole square plus 2 minus 1 becomes 1, which can be written as 1 square. So now you understand this complete integral has been changed into the form 1 upon root of x square plus a square, which resembles this form. So you can do directly here, in place of x we are having x plus 1. Or you can do one step more by taking x plus 1 is equal to t, because we are having only a single variable here, x. So we replace this x plus 1 by a single variable t, just to compare the equation with this given formula. So what does it become? Here dx is equal to dt, because the constant of 1 will be 0. So changing the complete integral, dx is equal to dt upon square root of x plus 1 is t, so it becomes t square plus 1 square. Now all of you can see it exactly resembles formula number 5th. So what is the formula? Log of x plus under root x square plus a square. So what is the answer here? In place of x we are having t. So log t plus under root of t square plus a square, that means 1 square, will again becomes 1 plus c. So please don't forget to replace the value of t. Here the value of t is x plus 1. So answer is log x plus 1 plus under root of x plus 1 ka whole square plus 1 plus c. Finally, you don't need to solve it. Always, whenever you will solve it, you will get the complete question, whatever that is given in the starting. So in the starting, we are having under root of x square plus 2x plus 2. When you will solve, always you will get the complete quadratic equation that is given in the starting. So replace this log x plus 1, or you can solve it also, you will get the same term, x square plus 2x plus 2, hardly matters. X square plus 2x plus 2 plus c. So this is our final answer. Please note down. So students, let's see question number 11. That is, we are having 1 upon 9x square plus 6x plus 5. Again, you can see here that we are having a quadratic equation in the denominator. One thing you have to remember that in exercise 7.1, 7.2 and 7.3, we have to think about the ideas for which we have to solve or we have to apply in a particular question so that our integration can be solved. But in this type of question, these are quite simple because we don't need to think about anything. We have to just follow the steps, particular steps for the solving this type of equation, that is having any quadratic equation in the denominator. So we are following the complete square method. So first step is that we have to make a coefficient of x square is equal to 1, right? So here you can see here the x square of coefficient, the coefficient of x square is 9. So what we have to do, we have to take 9 common. So what do we get? We get 1 by 9 if I have taken common. So it becomes x square plus 6 by 9x plus 5 by 9 dx. Now it becomes 1 upon x square plus, we can cancel it on the table of 3. So we get 2 by 3x plus 5 by 9 dx. Now just see here, what is the coefficient of x? Here the coefficient of x is 2 by 3. So if you will do the rough calculation, so what is the coefficient of half of coefficient of x? That is half of 2 by 3. So it becomes 1 by 3. So that means we have to add and subtract 1 by 3 whole square. So what do we get? See the next step. So we get x square plus 2 by 3x plus 5 by 9 plus 1 by 3 whole square minus 1 by 3 whole square. Now the next step is very simple. I told you don't need to think about anything. Just write down here x and whatever you have taken here as a square, you have to write down that term only. And in between you have to take plus and minus sign, that depends upon the coefficient of x. So here we are having plus, so we get plus here. Now the remaining terms are this one. So 5 by 9 minus 1 by 9. Now 5 by 9 minus 1 by 9 will become 4 by 9. And all of you know that the 4 by 9 can be written as 2 by 3 whole square. So it can be written as 2 by 3 whole square. Why I am writing down here 2 by 3 whole square? Because all the formulas are there in the form of x square plus a square or a square minus x square, whatever. Both the terms should be in square. So now I have changed both the terms in the form of a square, but we are having a single formula. Means single term in each question, in each formula, you can see we are having only x. So better to replace this x plus 1 by 3 by a new variable t. So let x plus 1 by 3 is equal to t. So here I get dx is equal to dt. So this given equation becomes, see here, 1 by 9 integration dt upon, this will become t square plus 2 by 3 whole square. So t square plus 2 by 3 whole square. Now it resembles the formula of type 3rd, which is equal to 1 by a tan inverse x by a. So just apply the formula. 1 by a is here 2 by 3. Tan inverse x is here t and a is here 2 by 3 plus c. So you can cancel this by 3. 3 into 2 will become 6 tan inverse. This 3 will come in the numerator, so it becomes 3t upon 2, 3t. Replace the value of t, that is x plus 1 by 3 upon 2 plus c. Simplifying it, we get 1 by 6 tan inverse. If you multiply this equation by 3, you get 3x plus 1 upon 2 plus c. So this is our final answer. I hope that you understood the main steps that we have to follow in these type of questions. So students, moving on to question number 12, that is integration of 1 upon square root of 7 minus 6x minus x square. Again, we are having a quadratic equation in the denominator but in the form of a square root, but that doesn't matter. You have to follow the same steps. So first step is that we have to make the coefficient of x square is equal to 1. Here the coefficient of x square is equal to minus 1. That means we have to take negative common. So see here, I will take negative common, so it becomes positive. 6x will become positive and 7 will become negative. one mistake that the students do, that they take minus sign outside. We can't take this sign, this negative sign outside, because you know that root minus 7 cannot be written as minus root 7, because it is actually root 7 iota. Root minus 1 can be written as root 7 can be written as minus 1 into 7. Now all of you know that minus 1 is equal to iota square. So the value becomes root 7 iota. So please remember this thing, that always you have to use this minus 1 in the inside the square root. You don't take it outside. Please remember this thing. So now moving on to the next step. That is, we have to add and subtract half the coefficient of x. So here we are having the coefficient of x is equal to 6, and half of 6 will become 3. So that means we have to add and subtract half the coefficient of 3 whole square. So the next step becomes 1 upon square root minus. So I told you x and whatever the term is there, 3 whole square, and plus and minus depend upon the coefficient of x. This is in plus, so we get plus here. And minus 7 minus 3 square will become 9 dx. So it becomes 1 upon square root of negative. Now x plus 3 whole square minus 7 minus 9 will become minus 16 dx. So finally, again, as we are not having any formula for minus of x square minus a square, you can see here. So again, we have to take this minus sign inside this term. So we get this 16 as positive, and all of you know that the 16 can be written as 4 square. So this minus minus becomes plus, and minus of x plus 3 whole square. Now all of you can see that this is the formula of type 1 upon root a square minus a square x square, which resembles formula number 4th, and the formula is sine inverse x upon a plus c. So you can do it directly, sine inverse x. Here in place of x, I am having x plus 3. So x upon a, what is a here? 4 plus c. So this is the answer, please note down. So students, next question number 13, that is 1 upon square root of x minus 1, x minus 2. So first of all, you have to change it in the form of quadratic equation. If you will solve this, you will get x square minus 3x plus 2. Fine, you will just open this and multiply these two terms, you will get x square minus 3x plus 2. Now, applying the complete square method, the first step you don't need to do, because the coefficient of x square is equal to 1. So the next step that you have to do, add and subtract half the coefficient of x whole square. So coefficient of x is 3. So 3 half means 3 upon 2. So you will add and subtract 3 upon 2 whole square. So we are adding 1 plus 3 by 2 whole square minus 3. So students, next step is change it in the form of complete square. So x, and here term is 3 by 2. Whole square. In between we have to take here negative sign, because here the coefficient of x is negative. Now these three terms have been included in the formula, and the remaining terms are 2 minus 3 by 2 whole square will become 9 by 4, because 3 square is equal to 9 and 2 square is equal to 4. Further, you can do, this can be written as x minus 3 by 2 whole square plus. If you will take LCM, 4 will be LCM, 4 into 2 will become 8. 8 minus 9 is equal to minus 1. So it becomes minus 1 by 4. And all of you know that minus 1 by 4 can be written as minus 1 by 2 whole square. Because always you have to form in the form of x square minus a square. So you can directly apply the formula. Now you can see here from the question, this is resembling, this is formula number 6. See here, so the formula is log x plus under root of x square minus a square. So just replace x by here, x minus 3 by 2 plus under root of x square minus a square plus c. Finally, what you need to do, you have to follow, you have to solve this equation. And I told you, please don't waste time to solve this equation. You will get again the same complete equation, whatever there is there in the starting. So we are having x minus 1 into x minus 2. So it becomes x minus 1 into x minus 2 plus c. You can see when you will solve this, you will get x square minus 3x plus 2, which again can be written as root a into x minus 1 into x minus 2. So this is our final answer. Please note down. Students, our next question is question number 14. That is integration of 1 upon root 8 plus 3x minus x square. So again, we are having a quadratic equation in the denominator. But one thing that we are having, the coefficient of x square is negative. So first of all, we have to make it positive. But remember this thing that you can't take this negative sign outside this square root. I told you, because this becomes complex number, you can't take this number, this negative sign outside. So it becomes minus of x square minus 3x minus 8. Now the next step, you have to follow complete square method. So for that you have to add and subtract half the coefficient of x whole square. So here the coefficient of x is 3. So 3 half means 3 upon 2. So you will add 3 upon 2 whole square and subtract 3 upon 2 whole square. Right? Now the next step is 1 upon square root minus. Now told you my shortcut trick, just write down here x and whatever the square you are adding and subtracting 3 by 2 whole square. In between it will come negative sign because the coefficient of x is in negative sign. Now write down the remaining terms, that is minus 8 minus 3 by 2 whole square becomes minus 9 by 4 dx. Now it becomes further 1 upon square root of negative x minus 3 by 2 whole square minus. Then you will take the LCM, 4 into 8 becomes 32. So minus 32 minus 9 becomes minus 41 upon 4 whole square. Now you know that 41 upon 4. Now just insert this minus sign, or you have to multiply this term with the minus sign. So it becomes positive. And 41 upon 4 can be written as root 41 upon 2 whole square. Because we have to change this integral into the standard form so that we can apply the formula. So it becomes root 41 upon 2 whole square minus of x minus 3 by 2 whole square. Now you can see that this is the formula of the type 1 upon root a square minus x square, whose formula is sine inverse x upon a plus c. So just apply the formula sine inverse x. In place of x we are having x minus 3 by 2 upon a. In place of a I am having root 41 upon 2 plus c. Now you have to just simplify and you will get the answer. Taking the LCM 2, we get 2x minus 3. And now you know that this LCM 2 will be cancelled by this 2. So in the denominator, we get only root 41 plus c. So this is the answer. Please note down. So students, next question number 15 is 1 upon square root of x minus a into x minus b. Now this question exactly resembles question number 13. Just you have to place a and b here in terms of in place of constants. So you have to follow the same steps. First of all, you have to open this equation. You will get x square minus a plus b into x plus ab. When you will open it, you will get this quadratic equation. Now using the complete square method, we will add and subtract half the coefficient of x whole square and subtract also. So here the coefficient of x is a plus b. So a plus b, when we will do the half of this, we will get a plus b upon 2. As the coefficient of x is a plus b, so when we will take the half, it becomes a plus b upon 2. So we will add and subtract a plus b upon 2 whole square. Now told you, without wasting the time, just write down the term. This will be x a plus b by 2. Just don't forget to write down in the form of bracket. And in the middle, plus and minus depends upon the coefficient of x. If it is negative, then we are going to place here negative. If it is positive, then we have to write down positive.
And whatever the third and the fifth term is there, that will be left over. Minus a plus b upon 2 whole square dx. Now we have to simplify just these two terms and then at last you will apply the formula. So just see how to do this. When you will do the square of this, it becomes 2 square is equal to 4. So directly I am taking the LCM 4. So 4ab minus, when you will open this term a plus b whole square, you will get a square plus b square plus 2ab. But outside this bracket we are having negative sign, so all sign will be changed. Plus will become minus, as we are having a square plus b square plus 2ab, but here we are having negative sign, so all the terms will become negative, that is minus a square minus b square minus 2ab. So finally we get it. Square root of x minus a plus b upon 2 whole square, it becomes, take the negative sign outside, you will get a square positive, b square positive, and 4ab minus 2ab becomes plus 2ab. But here you have taken negative common, so you will get minus 2ab upon 4. Now all of you know that whenever you have to use this formula, you have the integral in the form of square root of x square plus a square or x square minus a square. So we have to make this term in the form of a square. And all of you know that a square plus b square minus 2ab is the formula of a minus b whole square. So that's it. We have made this in the form of x square minus a square. So this is x minus a plus b by 2 whole square minus, this is actually a minus b upon 2 whole square. You can see here, when you will open this, a minus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab, and 2 square is equal to 4. Just apply the formula. You can see that this is a formula of this type. Dx upon under root of x square minus a square, whose formula is log x. What is x here? X minus a plus b upon 2. So this is the formula, x minus a plus b upon 2. Plus under root of x square minus a square, that means x minus a plus b upon 2 whole square minus a minus b upon 2 whole square plus c. Now no need to waste the time to solve this equation. You know that when you will solve the equation, you will get the complete quadratic equation that we are having in the starting. So in the starting we are having x minus a into x minus b. Either you can solve it also, you will check that this will be same. So you will just write down that directly the term will be x minus a plus b upon 2 plus under root of, this will be changed into the given quadratic equation, that is x minus a into x minus b plus c. So I hope that you understood the main concept. Please note down. So students, next see question number 16, that is integration of 4x plus 1 upon square root of 2x plus x minus 3. Although it is in the form of linear equation upon a quadratic equation, but first see that the derivative of quadratic equation is there in the numerator. Can't you see that the derivative of 2x square is equal to 4x and the derivative of x is equal to 1? That means this is in the form of f dash x upon fx. So why to waste our time in applying that trick of linear equation? We'll just put this function is equal to, as you know, from the starting, whatever the function is there, if it is in square root, I am putting t square just to simplify it. You can put it t also, you will get the same answer. But to simplify it, I am putting 2x square plus x minus 3 is equal to t square. In exercise 7.1, 7.2, 7.3, you can see my videos. All the questions where there is square root, I have put this function is equal to t square. This will make your question very easy. So let's see. Let 2a square plus x minus 3 is equal to t square. So differentiating both sides with respect to x. So we get 4x plus the derivative of x will be 1 and the derivative of 3 will be 0. Dx is equal to the derivative of t square will be 2t dt. Now just put the value in the given integral. So 4x plus 1 dx will become 2t dt upon square root of this function is t square, and all of you know that 2 can be taken outside t, and square root of t square will become t. So you see how simple it becomes. Both the t has been cancelled. The integration of 1 with respect to t is t. So answer is 2t plus c. Finally, don't forget to put the value of t from here. From here, t is equal to square root of this function. So these are the simple tricks that you have to follow. The final answer is 2x square plus x minus 3 plus c. Please note down. This is our final answer.